Well, former Venues New South Wales boss Tony Shepherd has been announced as the new chairman of Sydney's Entertainment Quarter. He may have only signed the contract yesterday, but he already has big plans for the city, hoping to revamp the precinct with a new luxury hotel, world-class restaurants and upgraded sporting facilities. Joining me live now is the man who wears many hats, Tony Shepherd. Thanks so much for your time. Good to see you. Congratulations. Now, you're never afraid to court controversy, do some radical things that the community wants. So what's at the top of your list, Tony?
Well, Laura, the top of our list is to integrate this wonderful precinct with that of the Disney Studios, incredible, with the SCG and Sydney Football Stadium next door, and make this a sports and entertainment hub for Sydney, for Australia, in the most beautiful city in the world.
Yeah. It is the most beautiful city in the world. We're not biased at all as we sit here and discuss that. Tony, look, it has been, it has had revamps, it has had a few facelifts over the years, but what's the biggest problem? Is part of what you'll be campaigning for is a lift on that cap for how many concerts can be at the stadium next door?
Yeah, that's true. That's in the same spirit. What we want to do is make serious investment in terms of sports and entertainment in this precinct. And when I say sport, everything from community to elite. There will be a focus on women's sport, for example. We also want in entertainment live music venues, you know, for small or large. They had a wonderful concert here this week, which was a sellout, and everybody had a great time. So we want to get more of that going. What the EQ needs is more events, more attractions, and so that more people are attracted to come here. And I've been told we will maintain the markets, which are extremely popular. So we really need the facilities, the events that will bring people here to EQ. And we are prepared to make very heavy investment to let that to make sure that occurs.
And Tony, what you're saying about the EQ could be said more broadly about Sydney. When you look at Sydney as an international city, it really lets itself down when it comes to nightlife. What do you think can be done more broadly across the city, and why do you think Sydney's in the position it is? Yeah.
Well, I don't know. For some reason, I don't know whether it's the nonchalance coming from living in a great city or what, or maybe arrogance, I don't know what it is, but Melbourne has gone way ahead of us. Mm. And really, it's a question of the facilities and the events. And that requires investment. And we are offering this as the private sector to make that investment. This is not going to be on the taxpayer. This is going to be a private sector investment. And this is part of the plan to transform Sydney into the wide awake, attractive city that people from all over the world and Australia want to come.
That's a really important point to make, Tony. You don't have your handout for a handout, but I guess you do need a state government, perhaps at a federal level too, I don't know, to come to the party on this when it comes to regulation. Do you have anything in mind?
Oh, look, we will need an extension to the lease, because you make this sort of highly significant investment, you've got to have a reasonable period to pay back. So, the lease would have to be extended, to enable us to recover our investment in this fantastic facility. So, and obviously, in things like regulation and car parking and what have you, well, we need cooperation from the state government, absolutely, and encouragement.
Do you think you've got a bit of a problem, Tony?
Put a proposal to them soon.
Yeah, sorry to interrupt you, mate. Do you think you've got
Look, I don't. Look. Sorry.
All right, let me go. Do you think you've got a bit of a problem with NIMBYism, not in my backyard, with a few of your neighbours there, or do you think you can charm them?
I think we can charm them. Look, we got a call this morning from somebody in Cooks Road saying they can hardly wait for it to happen. that's a good reaction from a local. I'll get that person's number and name and number. I'll get free tickets.
they confront the campaign.
I've got a lot of friends that live in this in this precinct, and they're all very excited about the prospect. I think there is always that element of NIMBYism in any big city, but I think the overwhelming majority will be in favour. And we're here for the people of New South Wales and all of the people of Sydney, and they deserve it. And where else in the world can you have a sports and entertainment hub 1.5 kilometres from the centre of the city? I mean, it's a unique facility. It's an enormous opportunity. Now, we will put a proposal to the government. Of course, it's up to them to deal with it. And obviously, they'll be very careful in assessing it. But I was very encouraged recently by their quick response on this cap on the concerts next door, the ridiculous cap, and their preparedness to have that increased significantly. I take that as a very encouraging sign from the new government.
Yeah, I think so too. Before I let you go, as I mentioned at the outset, you're a man that wears many hats. Your former Treasury, your former venues at New South Wales. You also did that commission of audit for the Abbott government. We sit here today on Budget Day. Could you have imagined that a Labor government would deliver the first surplus in 15 years?
Yes, all that's great. And we should get down on our knees and thank our resources sector has produced that result. We have one of the most efficient and productive resource sectors in the world, and we should congratulate them and thank you, because they are the source of revenue, which is in fact pulling our budget back into order, and they should be supported and thanked for that contribution to our economy, which is under stress at the moment with very high inflation, high cost of living, those sorts of issues. So, yeah, the resources sector has really pulled the rabbit out of the hat. Yeah.
Yeah, certainly. Tony Shepherd, great to see you. Thanks so much.
Okay, Laura, my pleasure.